Hello everybody, this is AK, I'm back. So there will be another video scheduled for 8 p.m. later this evening. This video is kind of a spur of a moment thing. Okay, so in the last few videos, I talk about how things could possibly get worse and how things could be very bad next year, starting next year. In another video, I also talk about the problem with the Chinese real estate market. And in another video, I talk about how if the US were to go into recession, Singapore would not be immune. And this time we cannot depend on China to help the world because the Chinese have a huge problem on their hands and there's a collapse in their real estate sector, which accounts for 25% of the country's GDP. Right. And I say that the Chinese real estate is now seen as a number one source for the next global credit event. Right. In a survey done by Bank of America. Right. This was for investors that surveyed by Bank of America. And what disturbs me even more, and to affirm the pessimism surrounding the Chinese real estate sector, is a report by Reuters that says that even China's 1.4 billion population cannot fill all its vacant homes. Right, there's a former Chinese official saying this, and this was sometime in late September. That was just last month, right? I think that there's no smoke without fire, right? And we have to be very careful, and that's why I say I'm hoarding cash, I'm feeding my war chest, and I don't know what other people are doing. I'm just doing what I think is right. Right. So I'm just going to read you a section from the report by Reuters. As at end of August, the combined floor area of unsold homes stood at 648 million square meters, or 7 billion square feet. Right, this is the latest data from the National Bureau of Statistics. Right, so this is done by China itself. Right, it's not done by some country that's trying to destabilize China or to discredit China. Right, and 7 billion square feet of unsold homes is roughly equal to 7.2 million homes, according to Reuters calculation based on average home size of 90 square meters. That's a lot. And they say even China's population would not be enough to fill all the empty apartments littered across the country, right? A former Chinese official said in a rare public critique of the country's crisis hit property market. Right, China's property sector accounts for 25% of the country's GDP, and has slumped since 2021, right? With Evergrande Group, the Chinese giant Evergrande Group, defaulting on its debt obligations, right? Once China drew the three red lines, which are the clampdown on new borrowings, right? Because the Chinese government said it was unsustainable. Then later on, Country Garden Holdings followed, right? And it was close to default. And home buying sentiment has been depressed in China for a long time, right? So the amount of unsold homes that is tabulated by the latest data by the National Bureau of Statistics, what is worrisome is that it does not actually include the numerous projects that have already been sold but not yet completed due to cash flow problems. So this combined floor area of unsold homes is only for residential projects that has been sold and completed, but those sold and not yet completed is not included in the number, the 7 billion square feet. So that is actually going to, you can imagine, it's actually a bigger number than 7 billion square feet of, and I have no words, you know, at this point. So China is grappling with a serious issue here. It will not have the energy, the resources to help the rest of the world, right? If globally we see another bad recession. That's some food for thought. Okay, that's all for now. Watch out for the next video at 8 p.m. Bye-bye.